Good morning, dear children. Hope you all are doing well. Welcome you all to our online class of Sri Gokulam Public School, Guruvayur. So in previous class, we were discussing about magnets, uses of magnets, and we have also discussed about artificial and natural magnet. So today, let us discuss about magnetic and non-magnetic materials. What are magnetic materials? Materials that attract towards the magnet are known as magnetic materials. And non-magnetic, it means that do not attract towards magnet. So let us understand with the help of an activity. That some materials are attracted to the magnets and some materials are not attracted to the magnet. For example, iron nails, safety pin, coin, these objects attract the magnet. And if we talk about paper cup and plastic, do not attract to the magnet. So we understand that magnet attract certain materials, whereas some do not get attracted towards the magnet. Is sand or soil a magnetic or non-magnetic? Let us understand with the help of an activity. Now rub a magnet in the sand. Pull out the magnet. Are there some particles of sand sticking to the magnet? Yes. Through this activity, we found that the soil contained some iron particles. Try this activity near your home. Let us discuss about poles of magnet. Now, spread some iron filings on a sheet of paper. Now place a bar magnet on this sheet of paper. You will see that huge amount of iron filings are stuck to the two ends of the magnet. These two ends are the poles of magnet, North Pole and South Pole. Now we find that the iron filings are attracted more towards the region close to two ends of a bar magnet. Now you can do this activity using pins or iron nails in place of iron filings and also with magnets of different shapes. Now let us discuss about finding directions. Magnets were known to people from ancient times. Many properties of magnets were also known to them. You might have read many interesting stories about the uses of magnets. One such story is about an emperor in China. One such story is about an emperor in China. It is said that he had a chariot with a statue of a lady that could rotate in any direction. It had an extended arm as if it was showing the way. The statue had an interesting property. It would rest in such a position that its extended arm always pointed towards south. By looking at the extended arm of the statue, the emperor was able to locate directions when he went to new places on his chariot.
So basically, this statue of lady act as a direction finder for emperor, and that's how they used to locate places. So in fact, because of this property of magnets, magnets were widely used to find direction, especially in ships, which was used to sail over long distance in the oceans. So for navigation purposes, magnets were widely used.
What we have discussed?
Yes, we have discussed about magnetic and non-magnetic materials.
With the help of an activity, we learnt what are magnetic and non-magnetic materials. And we have also discussed about poles of magnet. Children, I have attached the URL video and notes. So all of you please copy the notes in your notebook, and please all of you attend the test paper and post it. Okay, see you in the next class. Till then, take care. Bye.